visual, you thought you may never see Muhammad Ali taking his act to the octagon. A lot of people out there betting on this man think he's going to realize success here tonight.
Well, why would you not expect it, right? The guy has done everything he has ever said he was going to do. He's going to go out, becoming the heavyweight world champion, becoming the greatest boxer the world has ever seen. This guy is a fearless competitor. He has tremendous hand speed, unbelievable footwork, but it won't be those gifts that a lot of the fighters at the UFC can have to mix with everything else.
Sort of felt like he had exhausted the boxing world, felt like this was the next professional challenge. Perhaps a case of be careful what you wish for. Muhammad Ali gracing the octagon.
Kick to the leg, and he throws those deep kicks to the body. He's long, he's 6'4 for the weight class, and he has learned masterfully how to fight with his height and his range. All those long-range weapons are John Jones' calling cards.
So just over 20 total strikes have landed for John Jones.
I mean, you don't get those opportunities very often. You gotta take full advantage of them when they're presented to you.
All right, so John Jones having his way with an opponent as we have come to expect in the octagon. He's got the long-range weaponry going to him.
I mean, it's the striking of Jones, his ability to set traps, his ability to make you fight at his range. When you can't close the distance on Jones, you will have problems. That's exactly what's happening with his opponent tonight. It's not, but they will get close enough to find success.
Well, you don't want to take too many kicks on that calf, and now it's starting to show some visible damage.
You can see the color starting to change on the calf. He's taking too many of his kicks. You don't really stand after you take a head kick like this. That is such toughness to keep him be on his feet right now.
So we cross the 30-second mark in our opening round. Back to his feet. Another round. How good was that? All right, so the fighter is able to mercifully make his way back to the stool, but this could very well be the end of the fight. You all can see the swelling on your mouth, and you hate to speculate, but that could be a broken jaw. All right, so back to the stools we go. They say defense wins championships, and he has not defended well tonight.
He hasn't tried.
You're in fight. Ready.
All right, round two. Well, John Jones showing you some of those new weapons here tonight. Mike Winklejohn is always fond of saying you don't see 30% of what Johnny Bones is able to do in the gym. And with every passing fight, starting to show you the new wrinkles, new weapons in person. The left punch is true. Now the right hand. Ooh, it looks like that shot was blocked. The left hook lands on the count. Thunderous leg kick grabs his opponent. Trying to stay upright, but man, that changed the complexion of this one.
Johnny's hurt. He's hurt really badly by that one big leg kick.
Big right hand lands. Oh, huge knee. Shots exchanged in the pocket there. 3 minutes to go. Tonight, I'm not sure what would top it. One of the best knockouts we've seen all year.
In a very long time. I have not seen someone look this good. He promised us something, and he delivered with that beautiful knockout.
Resides with Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Deans called a stop to this contest at 2 minutes, 44 seconds of round number two. Becoming the winner by knockout, John Jones!
All right, what a highlight here tonight. John Jones, your winner by KO. Some are surprised for the winner.